The Parisian Life, also known as Inside the Cafe, is an 1892 oil and canvas impressionist painting by a Filipino painter, sculptor, and revolutionary activist Juan Luna. This painting is one of the masterpieces Juan Luna created during his stay in Paris, France from October 1884 to February 1893. At present, the Parisian Life is owned by the GSIS Museum with Professor Eric Cerudo as the curator and is currently exhibited at the National Museum of Fine Arts of the Philippines in Manila.
As the world faces and addresses a new set of quality artists, some historical artworks still possess indistinct characteristics and embody diversified interpretations. One of these is the Parisian Life, which have been bringing a lot of reasonable curiosity and exposition to some analysts. It is, however, due to the unavailability to know and ascertain what did Juan Luna mean by his painting.
An artwork is an expression of someone's thoughts and emotions, or even a language of timely scenarios. Yet, the painting of Juan Luna, The Parisian Life, displays a message that have been unknown up to this time. Therefore, along the way, there had been experts and consultants who tried to interpret this painting, and they came up to branch out their interpretations into literal, biographical, tragic, and symbolic and historical.
Now, let us move on to the different interpretations of the said painting. The painting was interpreted in several ways. One famous version of interpreting the Parisian Life painting is the Kwentong Barbero version, or the literal interpretation. It focuses on the literal coherence of the character's positioning and facial expressions. Characters include the three noblemen at the side and the mademoiselle sitting at the center, who is an alleged prostitute. This version simply explains the story behind, which talks about the three men who were seated together in a certain coffee shop in Paris, where they gossip over the prostituted lady who is wearing a flamboyant dress.
Similar to our previous interpretation, the next one takes the account of the character's physical circumstances. Secondly, the biographical interpretation. The biographical interpretation pictures out a deeper understanding on why these characters are showing such positioning, expression, and gestures. It says that one of the three men is a husband of the mademoiselle, and he is complaining to his colleagues about his wife having an affair with somebody.
Going on, next is the symbolic and historical interpretation, which reflects a lot of symbols or embodiment seen on the painting and relating those to our historical antecedents. In this interpretation, those three men were Jose Rizal, Ariston Bautista Lin, and Juan Luna himself. The prostituted woman, which is considered as the main subject of the painting, is like the mirror image of the map of the archipelago of the Philippines. It is not only because of her body figure, which looks like a reverse image of the archipelago. Instead, there were also coincidences that are also illustrated on the lady. What you are about to see may either be coincidences or the real basis of Juan Luna when he created this painting. Either way, it was an intelligent interpretation for us. If we look closely at the canvas, the lady's tears match the Batanes group of islands. Her waist matches the NCR region. Her knees, where everyone kneels and pray, match to Cebu on the map where Roman Catholicism started. And their left arm matches the whole Palawan area. Therefore, the lady indeed represents the archipelago of the Philippines. Moreover, the lady appears to be devastated, wherein the painting shows there's a rope that is strangled on her neck and also a rope lined over her head. This image has something to do with the struggles of every Filipino as they were being colonized before.
Moving on to the last interpretation, we want you to know that the Philippines before was poor and a country without independence. Thus, we call the last interpretation as the tragic interpretation. This interpretation is also related to our historical antecedents but mainly focuses on the socio-economic life of two countries during the time where independence is still far-fetched for the Philippines. Juan Luna's The Parisian Life depicts the socio-economic state of France and the Philippines. What is the social status of France in the year 1892? By a keen observation in the painting highlighting the role of the woman, the country is rich. Although the woman portrays wealthiness, her posture and facial expression explain that she is unsatisfied to what she possesses. Her face looks calm, but the vibe is still unhappy.
The woman in the art represents the Philippines. This representation translates the situation of the Philippines under the Spanish colonization, melancholic and tragic. The country of the Indios in that era needs purification and change, despite the fact that we are being colonized by the rich Western country. The isolation of the woman from the three men explains the objective of the Philippines. It is to detach the country from invaders. The second explanation is about setting aside native men from the mixed-race individuals. The woman delineates the encounters of the native Filipinos. This scene creates the idea that there is undeniable gap to these two sides, from their social class, occupation, to education. It was presented through the distinction of their clothing. In this interpretation, the whole illustration of the painting was a view of the difference of Juan Luna's life in the Philippines and Paris, France.
The Parisian Life truly approaches to different interpretations from different people. This particular artwork of Juan Luna is indeed wonderful and embodies manifold yet admirable meaning for everyone. Through these different variations of interpreting the painting, people were able to grasp and understand the early Filipinos' way of life while they were under the control of the colonizers. Chances are, these interpretations presented may or may not be the real exposition of the artist himself. However, we have at least opened the possibilities of what does the painting talk about.